Hi, my name's Tim Stout, and while we are all mourning Mina's death, I think it's appropriate that we celebrate her life. So I'm going to tell my favorite Mina Cheung story, and it really does capture who Mina was and kind of what she meant to all of us, especially to me. I first met Mina when she was a first-year resident at Doheny. She was bright, she was great, she was superb with patients. She was an excellent surgeon. After I came back to be chief resident, I spent a year away at Moorfields, and after I came back to be chief resident, Mina was a third-year resident. And one day, Mina asked me to come to clinic to see a patient of hers. So I walk into the room, and there's a child sitting in the chair with strabismus. And she points to the child. She said, I'd like you to examine this patient, which I was happy to do. And I think most of you know that I'm a retina specialist. So, you know, my first question to Mina was, you know, I'm a retina specialist. Why do you want me to look at this child with strabismus? And she said, no, look behind me. And so I turned around and I looked at the rest of the family that were in the room. And there were four kids against the wall, and they all had the exact same strabismus. And Mina said, I think this is more than just garden variety strabismus. I think this is Duane syndrome. And I think that it's all genetically determined. So I said, well, okay. So that is quite interesting. They were there with their mother. And so Mina had the great sense to ask the mom, you know, is there anybody else in your family with Duane syndrome, with this problem? And the mom said, oh, we have a huge family. Half the people in the family have this problem. So right then, Mina spent probably the next hour assembling a pedigree from this mom. And as it turns out, at the end of the day, it was a pedigree that listed something like 170 people, something like 80 of them or 90 of them. This mother was able to remember their name and remember whether or not they had it. So it was clearly an autosomal dominantly transmitted Duane syndrome. So Mina said, well, you know, if we've got this family, why don't we go ahead and draw their bloods and maybe we could map the Duane's gene. I said, well, that's ambitious. That's a great thought. Let's go ahead and do it. She goes, well, there's only one problem. Half the family lives in Los Angeles and half the family lives in small villages throughout Oaxaca, Mexico, the southern state in Mexico, where by the way, at that time, they were having armed rebellions. So I said, look, I think it's worth it. So we wrote a grant, we got funded. Mina and I spent 3 weekends driving around all of Los Angeles County, and we drew probably 50 or 60 different bloods from people in Los Angeles County. And then we partnered with our friend Mark Borchert from Children's Hospital of Los Angeles. And we all flew down to Oaxaca, Mexico. We rented a Jeep. I think actually some of the places between some of the cities, between some of these little burgs that we needed to go to, we actually rode donkeys. But we went to 20 or 30 little small communities, really, really very tiny communities. And we drew about another 70 or 80 bloods. Mina cataloged them all. She made DNA from them all. And at the end of the day, we were the first group to map the Duane's retraction syndrome gene to chromosome number 2. So that was an awful lot of fun, and that was because of Mina's insight that we were able to do it. The funny part was that for years thereafter, Ron Gross and Steve Ryan, whenever we had a interview session for potential residents, they would always drag Mina and me to lunch, where one of their questions would be, so are we allowed to do research? And Ron or Steve would say, well, how interesting. Let's ask Tim and Mina about their experience. And Mina and I just came to really laugh at these sessions because we were clearly being dragged out into a dog and pony show. But it was successful. We had a great time doing it. I think the perfect celebration of Mina's life. She saw a problem, she came up with a solution, she wrote a grant, we had a heck of a time in Oaxaca, drawing all these bloods. And then it was productive. At the end of the day, the gene was cloned as a consequence of this effort. So, as I said before, while we are mourning Mina's death, remembering her and celebrating her life should be at the front of our minds. Mina, we're gonna miss you.